the second week in a row, gas prices dropping slightly just in time for the weekend. That may change as the global community is keeping an eye on tensions that could tip the scale. Action News reporter Matt Pritchard is live at our Hearst, Washington Bureau with more on what has experts concerned. Matt, good morning.
Hi, good morning, Dan. Well, OPEC, Venezuela, and Iran, those are all things that are on experts' radar, as those actions from those countries can really pay a price at the pump.
This is a bit of an atypical summer.
Prices at the pump staying low for the moment.
This year, we've seen prices actually decrease, some of which has actually been because of lower demand.
The national average is at $2.85 for regular, 10 cents cheaper than this time last year.
AAA expects that prices will probably continue to decline an additional 5 to 10 cents.
But that's where the good news starts to fall short.
Once the summer begins, we will enter into an era of volatility.
The price of gas hinges on global politics, with experts in part focused on the Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, or OPEC.
One of those concerns would be whether or not OPEC and its partners decide to extend the production reduction agreement.
That agreement was made to raise crude oil prices following a dip in 2018 profits. Reduced exports from countries like Iran and Venezuela aren't helping either. But some experts are staying positive.
If you step back and take a long view of things and take a view of where we were and where we're headed, America's energy future is really bright.
Frank Macurola says while prices fluctuate, America is making more of its own oil, and that benefits consumers.
The trend is a positive one.
And while that won't help your wallet this summer, AAA says,
watch the market and to understand that there are many forces that are impacting prices.
Now, AAA estimates 37 million drivers will be making their ways onto the roads this weekend. And unfortunately, because of all that demand, we could see a price spike coming later on next week. Dan?
Thank you very much, Matt. So real quick, how do gas prices in California, we know we're way more, but how do we compare really?
That is a dreaded question. I was dreading it all morning. Obviously, yes, California is paying quite a bit more. $2.85, you heard, was the national average, and I'm sure most of your viewers would take that. California is all the way up at $4.03 as the average. That's even higher than you were at last year, $3.71, the average in 2018.
Matt Pritchard, live from Washington this morning. Thanks for the cheery news, Matt. Appreciate it. Have a great holiday. Here on the Central Coast, the average cost for a gallon of gas is $4.10. In Monterey County, $4.06 in Santa Cruz and San Benito County.